Hello, everybody. We are fortunate here today to have Dr. Biju Toms with us, who is the head of Department of Professional Studies at Christ University. Welcome, Dr. Biju Toms. It's a great honor and a privilege to be interviewing you for this particular episode. How has the partnership with SEMA provided value to the management degree programs at Department of Professional Studies at Christ University, sir?
See, this is a decade of collaboration and cooperation with CIMA. And this was initially, when we discussed at the department, we had quite a lot of skepticism, like how it will fructify. But we are very confident and we are very happy and proud that the cooperation has really done well to our students. Especially today, in this world where mobility is very, very important,
right.
Global mobility. Today we have quite a large number of students dispersed all over the globe. And they are all doing exceptionally doing well. And I must thank CIMA for the support. Most importantly, in terms of the curriculum support.
Right.
Because for us, what we found was when we maintained the syllabi, which is actually meeting the requirements of the regulators and the expectations of mm-hmm. the stakeholders, what we found that CIMA curriculum syllabus helped us to reach out to the global audience. And the global perspectives that we could gain from CIMA has literally helped our students to do exceptionally well. Now, to give one or two examples, let me tell you, when students in the first batch, when they completed the undergrad program, that is become professional program, and during the time of their progression, when mm-hmm. we send them to corporates for internships, the corporate's feedback was very good.
Okay.
They said, how did the students get these kind of insights, which they were giving it to the employees, the existing employees, as part of their on-the-job training.
Right.
So this was one of the very good move from the department, and I must thank my management as well.
Right.
Especially former Vice Chancellor Father Thomas C. Matthew, and also the others in the hierarchy for supporting us, because this was a huge risk that we had taken, and
right.
it really, really paid off.
Fantastic. That's great to hear. With technology today disrupting businesses and upending business models, and with the advent of AI and automation today also impacting the world of finance, what are the key skills and competencies today that you see and that you hear when you interact with corporates that they look out for students who are graduating fresh out from the universities?
See, now it has become a cliche when corporates and maybe bodies like CII and others come and tell us that university graduates are unemployable. Generally, this is the statements made by them. What we found mainly with the Association of CIMA, especially I was so fortunate to have associated with the Lifelong Learning Committee, where the syllabi of CIMA for 2015 was drafted. I was part and parcel of the committee. I felt so happy the way CIMA drafted the curriculum. So the major thing which makes CIMA distinct from other professional bodies, I felt, was that their approach of looking ahead and pedal, because they are not looking at the present status and try to enhance those kind of qualities within. But looking ahead into the future was one of the key differentiator for CIMA.
Right.
So having said that, what I find that in the present syllabus also, how digital learning and how digital learning is going to enhance the student expertise in terms as a key differentiator is something which I really appreciate. And since we had a briefing about what the CIMA curriculum, the future curriculum is going to be,
right.
we were also discussing and deliberating with the corporates. We have, luckily for our campus, we get around, say, with startups and the multinationals, we get around 200-250 corporates coming into the mm-hmm. campus, and mm-hmm. with every corporate, when they come, we ask them what is the kind of changes that they are looking at. And we find that what they are saying and what Seema has integrated in their curriculum are in perfect sync.
Right.
So, for example, when we were in the discussion and when we were talking to CIMA syllabus makers, I found that analytics is a key area.
Right.
So, therefore, we've been able to incorporate key essential areas of analytics at the undergrad curriculum itself. Mm-hmm. And when we send the students first time into the internship,
right,
everybody gave a thumbs up. See, we have sent our students to Bosch, we have sent them to Grant Thornton,
right,
we have sent them to Ernst & Young. They were all appreciating the dynamic changes that we have incorporated in the curriculum.
Right.
So therefore, going forward, we need to really, really look at what the disruptions that are happening in the outside world.
Mm-hmm.
But more importantly, we should be looking at how these key skill sets can be seamlessly integrated in our curriculum.
Very well said. This is a triple celebration for us. Hmm. CIMA is celebrating its centenary year this year, 2019. CRICE is celebrating its 50th year. And together, we are celebrating our 10th year. It's been a decade of this wonderful, wonderful partnership. Sir, how do you see this partnership going from here?
See, one of the key aspect which whenever people from outside ask me what makes CRICE University unique,
right,
I always say that there is a distinct learning environment in this campus. So having said that, and also the management always looking towards future and very futuristic, mm-hmm. and you see there is a lot of uncertainties happening outside, I think it is of a mutual learning and cooperation. Together, it's what we call it as the interdependence. For us, probably with our own academic strength, it might not yield us this kind of a results that mm-hmm. we are looking at. Today, many companies come asking for us students in terms of employees, and also in second year itself, they want the students to come for internships. So going forward, one or two major aspects which I look at is how do we together work together and see that the blended curriculum mm-hmm. is making a sense to the corporates outside. And for that, probably the learning and development division of the corporates, we need to have a constant dialogue,
right,
which I've seen that it is already paying off. That is one thing. Second, I felt is the kind of the students who have progressed, or this we have tried and tested in some other places.
Right.
Even in our engineering campus, we are trying this.
That's right.
So the students who have already moved up in the career progression, they can go back and help those starters who are in the initial phase, maybe the BA2 level or maybe OCS levels. These people can go back and share their mm-hmm. Experience and maybe a little bit of expertise in mm-hmm. handling the kind of papers.
Right.
That will definitely pave way to enhancing the number of students, quality students passing out the program. And third, probably if I have to tell you, is that more of academia and industry collaboration,
mm-hmm.
how can we facilitate that? Because many a times academia is at a loss to understand what are the requirements of the industry. So is the case with the industries.
Right.
They probably many a times they come to the campus and they do not understand that such a thing is really happening.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe these three things, key aspects, if we work together, it okay. will make our students more employable. And more importantly, with CIMA, we often tell the students that we should be looking at that they should, instead of chasing the employment, they should be employment providers.
Right.
So I think CIMA is ideally set for, because unlike other professional qualifications, I find CIMA to be unique in majorly understanding the process of business and giving what are the identifying the gaps in businesses and how we can fill in that gap through the expertise of CIMA. So probably these are the areas where we should work together and see to that. It is not just confined to Christ University alone, but right. we are always keen on reaching out to other potential partners and players where our little kind of expertise and maybe the tradition that we have built in a decade
right.
can be used.
Thank you so much for these insights. I'm sure this partnership will go from strength to strength from here, and look forward to the next decade of this wonderful partnership. Thank you so much, Dr. Bindu.
Thanks.